Memphis, a man has been charged with eating potato chips because he had crumbs on his mouth. He did not steal the chips, ladies and gentlemen. Let's put up the picture full mask. This is an insane miscarriage of justice, in my opinion. In Memphis, Tennessee, a 36-year-old Joseph Braswell was taken into custody after Memphis police say he ate two bags of chips that someone else had stolen from the store. Now you may wonder, well, did he know the person that stole the chips? No. Braswell was charged with theft of merchandise less than $1,000. He was released on his own recognizance on Tuesday morning. That means the judge knew this was a BS charge and did not even charge the man money to get out of jail. According to WREG, CBS 3 Memphis, on the 9th of this month, February, a man got into an argument with a Circle K store clerk in Parkway Village because she would not sell him beer. The man got upset, then took an entire display of chips and put them into his car, all right? While walking away with the display of chips, a few of the bags fell on the ground as the clerk followed the man out of the store. You're looking at the scene right there. After the suspect drove off, Mr. Braswell picked up two bags of chips that had fallen. The chips were valued at $4.98 total. Minutes later, officers found Braswell with crumbs on his face. Police reviewed video footage and concluded that Braswell was aware of the theft. That's what I'm talking about, fellas. Real police work there. It's silly as hell. Okay? $4.98. Chips are on the ground. They come to the scene. And what do the Memphis police do? They waste time reviewing video about who picked up the damn bags of chips rather than finding the individuals who engaged in what they would consider, I guess, a high crime. Maybe all of the chips together, what, $100 probably? The man had crumbs on his face. And so that launched the investigation. There's more. Braswell's mother says she doesn't believe it was necessary to arrest him, the store manager. Melanie Jackson said, it is not about the bag or the bags of chips that were stolen. It is more about a pattern of stealing that she is concerned could run her out of business. She says small crimes like these are why so many businesses have left the area. Madam, please understand, the man who was arrested did not steal your chips. Theft requires intent. Theft requires mens rea, formulation, the idea that I'm going to go and steal chips from a commercial entity. That is not what he did at all. But he got arrested for it and you're standing by it. Doesn't make sense to me. There's more. Braswell's mother says she just wants to get him the help he needs. I called the crisis center. I called the police department. She said, I tried to get him assessed. And every time he goes downtown for something like this, they never assess him. Police are still looking for the man who drove off with the chips. And she wants an assessment because she believes he needs help. All right. Once again, the police decide a man, a black man, crumbs on his face. We must review the video to arrest him for $4.89. Memphis. It's insane. Do you wonder why people don't like the police? This is part of it, right here. Because none of us can understand this. I mean, really, think about it. And to the officers involved, you wouldn't understand it either if it happened to somebody in your family or if it happened to you or to one of your children. You would have said something like, the officer could have let that go. You didn't even steal the chips. But all of a sudden, when you put on that uniform, it seems as if your understanding of basic humanity evaporates. This is part of the reason why there's an us and them relationship with law enforcement. I want to help you all. I really do. I provide an opportunity right here on this show every day, a blueprint to get you back to the place that you were supposed to be, a place of public safety, not policing. A place of servant leadership and not dictatorship. That is the original design as it should have been, but it was not. It was something totally different. It was a way to regulate black bodies and protect white companies. That was the original design of law enforcement. Don't carry out the design. Break it. All right? Change it. Doc, what are your thoughts here?
There was no crime. He didn't steal any chips. There were chips on the ground. Maybe there's a story about the police saying, gosh, I'll just buy you two bags of chips and let's just actually go after the guy who really stole the chips. I didn't see that story. Maybe that story doesn't make it to the news. We only see stories like this. But I completely agree with you. This is exactly the kind of story that requires compassion. Compassion is really what's required here. Somebody's hungry. Two bags of chips is what, like less than $2, something like that. So buy the man some chips, don't arrest him. And I just think you're exactly right that in a way, the kind of compassionate enforcement that is required, which again, maybe that happens and we just don't see it because it doesn't make the news and it's not clickable. But I would just say, here's somebody who's hungry and needs help, and he didn't commit the damn crime, exactly as you say. Go after the guy who actually stole the stuff.
And what's so interesting, and you make a great point, police officers are not bound to arrest for misdemeanors. They're not. There's no mandate to arrest for misdemeanors that did not happen in their presence, meaning they did not witness it personally. They do not have a duty or a mandate to arrest. They can also write a ticket if they choose. But here's the other side of what you laid out for us. If one of the officers would have said, listen, come on, Madam Store Clerk, it's two potato chips, two bags. I'm going to go ahead and pay for these. I'm going to buy a few more things for the guy. We're going to try to get him help. That would have changed the whole narrative of this story. Something that simple, right?